IoT, Internet of Things, which is going to change the way we live and we work. And LoRaWAN is one of the technology which is helping out in the deployment of IoT networks. Ladies and gentlemen, in this lecture, I'm going to share 3 points about LoRaWAN, which will help you out to better understand about LoRaWAN. So watch this video till end. Let me share my PPTs with you. Although many technologies and communication protocol coexist in the IoT market for different applications, LoRaWAN is not the only technologies which is present in the market. There are many other such technologies or parallel technologies. Particularly, industrial IoT demands cost-effective, long-range, and power-efficient sensors and actuators. Though industrial IoT demands much something else, like it should be cost-effective, it should transmit to long-range, and it should be power-efficient. LoRa devices have revolutionized IoT by enabling data communication over a long range while using very little power. And LoRa devices are such devices which are fulfilling this condition very well. LoRaWAN is a LPWAN wireless wide area network technology which connects IoT device wirelessly. So LoRaWAN is one type of LPWAN wireless wide area network technology which connects IoT devices wirelessly. Before coming up on LoRaWAN, we must try to know types of computer networks. Broadly, computer networks are divided into four subcategories. Personal area network. Personal area network coverage or the signals confined into a single room. Or the coverage area is up to certain meters, for example, 10 meters. Local area network, confined only in a building or in a campus, approximately 100 to 150 meters. Metropolitan area, which provide the coverage of entire city, up to 15 kilometers or more. And wide area network, which can cover more than one country or maybe the entire world. So here we will talk about wide area network, that is WAN. Is it that we don't have any IoT technology presently, or they have some drawbacks? Yes, we have many technologies which can be part of IoT, but they have certain drawbacks, and let's find out what are those drawbacks. This is a graph between speed, power, and distances. You can see that is in PAN, there are many wireless technology available, Bluetooth, Thread, Zigbee, NFC, and RFID. They can transmit up to 10 meters, and they transmit from some BPS to kilobit per second and consume even less power. But drawback is they are not providing more coverage. LAN, Wi-Fi comes in under the LAN. It provides more than 100 meter coverage area, but it consumes more power, though data rate is quite good in Mbps. So this is the existing technology and their drawbacks. And then why we are moving to other technologies, which is known as the low power wide area network. Low power wide area network interconnects low bandwidth battery powered devices with low bit rates over long range to attain high energy efficiency. In IoT, there are certain applications when we require low data rates and need the life of network more than 5 years to 10 years on low bandwidth. LP WAN technology can be divided into three categories. LoRaWAN is not the only technologies which is fall under the category of LP WAN. There are more than that network based on cellular infrastructure like NB-IoT, network using third-party infrastructure, for example, Sigfox, autonomous LP network infrastructure. Here LP network comes. Available technology in LP WAN. So this is the same portion in PAN LAN which we have discussed, and we are just extending this figure up to here. LP WAN. LP WAN provides coverage area is starting from few meters to 10 plus kilometers, that is 15 kilometers. And it is using less power. Just you can see they are using so much less power. And though data rate is less, but it is the requirement of our application. It will work better. In WAN, we use more power, so the data rate is more. So as per the requirement, where we are going to deploy the network, we use the technology. LoRaWAN. The LoRaWAN is low power wide area networking. It uses low power. It is a global standard protocol designed to wirelessly connect battery power operated things to the internet, regional, national, or global networks. Let's see what are the various features of LoRaWAN. LoRaWAN offers several advantages. LoRaWAN provides long range bidirectional communication. It provides the coverage area up to 15 kilometers. It consumes less power. That is, things can be operated up to 10 years on the same battery. Transmit over license free RF bands like 160 megahertz, 430 megahertz, 868 megahertz, and 915 megahertz. And the very special point about these bands, these are the free license band. That is, they are fall under the unlicensed ISM band. What is ISM band? This is industrial, scientific, and medical band, which is license free. And that's why LoRaWAN is a very cost efficient network deployments. And it can penetrate deep, which has the ability to reach sensors, monitoring water or gas meters located underground. Because the range of the frequency is optimum, we have various relation between frequency versus distance, frequency versus losses. So if I talk, if the frequency is high, then coverage will be less. If the frequency will be high, the losses will be high. Because here frequency is optimum, it is appropriate. So they are able to penetrate obstacle easily. And thus they are able to reach to the sensors and vice versa. This is the LoRa network architecture. This is divided into AND devices, gateways, network server, application server. What are AND devices? These are the smart things or LoRa smart devices. Here we have a smart health system, a smart agriculture system, smart home buildings, smart metering, and they are connected with the LoRa gateways, LoRaWAN gateways, with the help of LoRa RF links, which the frequency which we have already explained. Further, gateways are the bridge between the AND devices and internet, that is network server. They pick up the information from smart devices and put it into the network server or internet, and here we are using the application. Here we can gather, we can analyze, read the data and act accordingly what we are required or what action we need to require today. So it was all about 3 points of LoRa: when, what is LoRa, how this is different, and architecture of LoRa when. How did you like the lecture? Kindly do share with me. If you have any doubt, anything which you did not get in the lecture, please mention in comment box. I will clarify it, but your feedback is important to me so that I can improve my own doubts. Ansar Ahmed signing out. Until we meet again.